Have you ever noticed that you seem to have a higher chlorine demand when phosphates are high? It's not actually a direct relationship with chlorine, it's an indirect relationship with chlorine. And in this video, I will explain why. Let's talk about outbreaks for a moment. Now, this is kind of a touchy subject because when we talk about outbreaks, we're not just talking about algae.
We're not talking about this or this, we're talking about this!
Any living organism in a swimming pool is what chlorine is designed to be in the pool to prevent. And I'll use chlorine generically. You may have bromine in your pool, but you get the point. What it really comes down to is a battle between the growth or reproductive rate of these microorganisms, bacteria, algae, whatever, versus the killing rate of your sanitizer. And this is a battle that's waging 24/7. Let's look at this as if it were a heavyweight boxing match. In this corner, in the growth rate corner, we're talking about the reproductive speed. And in order to reproduce any microorganism, including algae, you need nutrients. In swimming pools, usually they come in the form of orthophosphate and nitrates. These micronutrients fuel these contaminants to grow fast. In fact, in swimming pools, according to the textbooks, some of these species of algae can reproduce every 3 to 6 hours. Think about that. 3 to 6 hours and you could double the size of your algae colony if you're not fighting it. If the growth or reproductive rate of these contaminants exceeds the killing speed of chlorine, you get an outbreak. The killing speed is not just your free chlorine reading. You may have 10 parts chlorine in your pool, but if you have a lot of cyanuric acid in there too, you may not actually have the killing power that you think. What really matters is the free chlorine to cyanuric acid ratio. According to the textbooks in this industry, chlorine is the best algaecide. You just gotta give it a chance, because if it's too overwhelmed by the growth rate of these things and all the other stuff it has to deal with, that's when you get an outbreak. So while it may look to us like our chlorine demand is going up, 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 and we're fighting phosphates directly, we're not really fighting phosphates directly. We're actually fighting what they're fueling. These micronutrients are just helping the contaminants grow faster. Therefore, chlorine continues to get used up fighting them, and it's a losing battle. So who's gonna win the fight? Is it gonna be chlorine, or is it gonna be the microorganism contamination? Well, certainly we hope it's chlorine because we want to keep water safe. I'm Eric Knight with Orenda, and I hope this helps explain why your chlorine demand seems to be higher when you have high levels of phosphates. If you have any more questions, contact us directly, download our app, visit our website, orendatech.com, and like us on Facebook. Thanks.